Ranarangam, right? A new film. What is the core idea?
The core idea is from Godfather. For an audience to come to a theater, first is the star. Or it's Rajamouli and Trivikram. Whatever film you make, if you make in that budget and for that audience, you will never fail.
Hello, welcome to Film Companion South.
Thank you, Baradwaj, and it's my pleasure being here.
It's lovely to see you here. Now, before I begin, while we were just talking here, I noticed this Asian tattoo out here. What is that?
It's in Chinese. I can't tell you what is that, but if you ask me, I'll say Baradwaj. Whoever asks me, I say their name.
What is that?
That's the reason I get it in Chinese. So you can't take a picture and translate also, their language is too much complicated.
But somebody there should know, right?
Yeah, they should know.
What would they say?
I can't say that.
You have a tattoo in a very visible part of the body, you can't say what it
is. And I want everyone to keep guessing what that.
Okay, I asked your manager about three filmmakers I should ask you about. And I'm going to ask you about all the three filmmakers. The first one is Ram Gopal Varma. What is this? Of course, he's a great filmmaker. What he did is great, all that kind of stuff. But this, when I ask one particular generation of Telugu filmmakers to name that one guy, it's almost always Ram Gopal Varma. It's as if almost like for the newer generation, the Telugu cinema is pre-Ram Gopal Varma and post-Ram Gopal.
Pre-Shiva and after Shiva.
After Shiva. What is, from an insider point of view, because we come from the other, from an insider point of view, what is it about Ram Gopal Varma and Shiva that created such a pre and post in Telugu cinema?
I'll tell you my point of view, because I was very young when Shiva released. Till then, all commercial films and the songs, most of the films which you see pre-Shiva, after every song, there is a villain scene.
Okay.
That's how the format used to be. Okay. Most of the films. Shiva is a film which broke all the rules. And till that point of time, I was very young. I didn't know there was a director for a film. It was always my hero's perspective. And I see the hero, okay, this is the film. I don't know what goes behind everything to make that film and all. Right. After Shiva came, everyone started talking about Ram Gopal Varma.
Right.
Before that, there are great directors in Telugu.
Right.
Raghavendra Rao garu, Dasar Narayan Rao, they are huge. I know their names after I got to know about Ram Gopal Varma, and there is a craft called direction, and he is the one who makes everything.
Right.
The actor comes and acts however he wants and all. That's when I got to know about Ram Gopal Varma, and then I don't know, it might have put something in my mind to my journey to become a director.
Okay.
So that's the impact which gave. His second film, Kshanakshanam, is my all-time favorite film. It didn't work that much when it released because it's way ahead of its time.
Right.
People are not able to understand so many layers which are there in that. So that's when I started following Ram Gopal Varma, and all my age group, all the new generation directors and my seniors, people like Rajamouli garu or Vimal Naik garu, these are all. At that time, Ram Gopal Varma was a rage and he was like a god to us.
Right.
So, we all came into the industry keeping only Ram Gopal Varma in mind. When I was doing my engineering, most of the time I never used to go to college or anything. Movies. Each and every movie I used to see. That's when I got parents give you money to buy a computer, this thing and all, thinking that he becomes a computer engineer or he learns something. So the only use for us with that computer is to get a CD, rent a CD and watch a movie. So that's how it helped us, and that's when I got my exposure to the world cinema and all. So I did my engineering for my parents' sake. I was never wanted to go into this job thing and all. So after my engineering, my only intention was to go to Hyderabad or Bombay, meet Ram Gopal Varma and join as an AD for him.
Okay.
I thought that was the easiest job. That after coming to Hyderabad, I knew how tough it is. Not only to Ram Gopal Varma, to a normal director to become an AD, it is the toughest job.
Right.
So since you asked me about RGV, for me, he is God. Still, he is my God.
I was going to ask you this question later, but because you mentioned engineering, I'm going to ask it to you now. Why are so many people in the Telugu film industry engineers by profession, by qualification?
Is it because of what you said?
Because they all have computers and they can see the movies?
That's one reason. And the other reason is you have to ask our parents. Whenever we are like, after we come to a plus one, plus two, all our parents wants to see their children as engineer or doctor. That's the only reason. And at that point of time, you can't say no. And like, now it's okay. It's not that much now.
Okay.
When I was in my engineering and all, like my parents want me to become an engineer, no other alternate for that. So that's the reason.
So how do you think your parents are going to react if they see this interview and say,
the only reason
you got a computer is to watch movies?
I'll give you the story. After my engineering, my parents wanted me, one of my cousin's sister, first cousin, she stays in US. One of my aunt, she stays in Australia. They want me to go to US or Australia, anything. And my aunt and cousin wants me to come there. So they send me to Hyderabad, where my another aunt lives here. So to get this coaching for GRE, this thing and all, to go abroad. And if I want to study, I can study, or else do a job or something. That's when I came to Hyderabad. My aunt doesn't know, no one knows. I tried my thing with these filmmakers, this thing, going to their offices, meeting and all. And at that point of time, I wanted to join with Krishnavamsi. And 2 months I waited to meet him. That chance also I didn't get. Because I thought, now after me being a director, I know what that is.
The process is.
At that point of time, I used to think how much work does he have to meet one person kind of thing. But after me becoming a director and knowing people come to my office every day, 4 to 5 people, I try to meet them, but I can't make up a story to everyone.
Right.
So I have my department filled and all. So everyone wants to get into the department and all, and it's correct from their point of view. But if you ask my point of view also, it's I can't take many people. And through a friend, I got introduced to an AD. I used to travel with him, know about the filmmaking, this thing and all. And then slowly, he became a co-director for a film called The Angrez.
Okay.
So he took me as an AD for that film. That was my first film way back in 2005.
Right.
So from there, my journey started. And my parents still doesn't know that I am into this. They are still thinking I'm preparing for GRE film. One day, there is an article in a newspaper where the article was about the assistant directors. Dreaming big about their big day and all, that was the heading. And I was not part of that article, but one of my friend who was who gave this small interview for that paper, he gave a working still where we both are there for that newspaper. And in that paper, my relatives, my parents, everyone saw that. And then they got to know that I am into this thing. So a lot of fights happened. Fights in the sense they don't want me to get, because they're correct in that point of view. Because what I feel is for every 100 assistant directors, right, around 7 to 8 members become director.
Right.
And in that, 1 or 2 will become a successful director.
Right.
So the percentage is 1%, and no parent will allow their children to have to go to anything which has a success rate of 1%. But when we are in that zone, we think we are that 1%. So luckily, I'm surviving.
Will you allow your children?
Yeah, definitely.
You think things have changed now?
See, when I came into this, only film and you have to become a director. Now with this web things and all,
right, there are so many options.
And YouTube,
right.
At that point, if I want to make a short film, I have to invest a lot of money to hire a camera and all.
Right.
Now with a good mobile phone, you can easily shoot a short film.
Right.
Edit and all also easy. At that time, dumping everything is in that VHS cassettes and all. Now just email.
So the other two filmmakers your manager told me about were Mani Ratnam and Quentin Tarantino.
Yeah.
So you know this, right?
Yeah.
I mean, this is everyone knows this. So with Mani Ratnam again, he's made only one Telugu film, right? Gitanjali. Mm. But that has kind of become such a cult, not just cult in the sense, sometimes cult movies are you know, they fail, but they are worshipped by a small section. But this is a hugely successful film, but somehow it has stayed like over that generation. And of course, Tarantino. Just what are these two directors all about to you?
One of my friend, when I said when I was in engineering, I got this, I went to a movie. There, they used to have a digital movie theaters.
Okay.
Not a regular theater, this film will play. The digital movie theaters, they get a DVD, just like a big auditorium with seats, and they project on a screen, big screen with a DVD. And I went to see this film called Reservoir Dogs. The film started, it was going, I was very much into the film following it. Because his style is like, he starts a scene and 10 minutes they will be talking continuously. It's his style. And after 15 minutes, people started shouting to stop the film and put some other film. That's how I got to know about Quentin Tarantino. Then like they stopped the film, then they screened a film called Road Trip, which everyone loved. I came back, rented a DVD of Reservoir Dogs, watched it. And I was like awestruck. Oh, the film can be made like this. It's on a bank robbery, which he doesn't show a bank robbery.
Yeah.
But still, you are hooked into it. And then I saw this film called Pulp Fiction. And I was like, whatever might be the reason, he is my god. And then I started following all of his films after that. And see, the thing about Quentin Tarantino, we can't follow him for our thing.
Right.
Most of the thing, because his style and all works for that. Right. But our audiences are not into that zone where like you go on a conversation. For example, if you take that breakfast scene in Pulp Fiction, they start talking about this burger and cheese and the metric system and all. You, if you are following, you will love it.
Right.
But here, if you want to write a scene like that, you have to put the audience in mind, like how they feel and all. Like you are starting the film with that. If you, they get bored, and the now in our the generation which we are in, if we are not engaging for like 10 seconds, if we lose, he is opening his mobile phone and he's checking his WhatsApp or any Insta or something. To get back into the movie, we need something else to put in. So, whenever the audience comes, you have to put him hooked to the film so that he follows everything.
Right.
If you put a scene with that conversation, it's very hard for us to think. So, what I did is, in my first film, I wrote the whole story, everything, and I started writing the screenplay. Then, the film starts normally and goes, but I want the audience to be hooked by the first scene. That's when I got this idea from Pulp Fiction. Pulp Fiction, where he starts the film, the conversation between this honey bunny scene, where they start talking about these robberies and all, and then they come to the conclusion that robbing a restaurant will be very easy because no one will be expecting it.
Right.
So let's try rob this restaurant, and then they take up the guns, they freeze to that, and goes to the titles. That you, for the whole film, that is in your mind. Right. Why did he show that scene where it's not coming in the film till the climax thing? So that's when I got the idea of like, we have this two guys called Jogi Brothers in Telugu. They used to do this TV thing and they are very famous. So I started the scene with them.
Right.
They are talking about Silksmita. They start the conversation there. And then they are having tea. Suddenly they see a guy. And then no one will, from Telugu, will expect these two funny guys will kill a person.
Right, right.
That's when they take out the guns and kill a person.
Right.
And on their escape, his scooter won't start. So they're very scared and all. They see a Scorpio coming.
Right.
They stop that Scorpio, ask those people to get down. They get in the Scorpio and leave. That's the first scene of the film.
Right.
And in the second half, somewhere in the second half, I related that with the antagonist is kidnapping a hero and his friends and all. And when they are on the car going, suddenly two people come and stop the car, ask them to get out, and they take the car away. I related that scene to this fellow, well, people doesn't expect. And at that point of time, hero wants some reason to escape from that.
Right.
So that's the reason I linked it and everyone loved it. So I get inspired like that. that scene is different from the scene from Pulp Fiction, but yeah. I generally I got it and made it down to Telugu, like how this audience will love it, and all. Okay. Then I kept it like that. Yeah. So like there are few dialogues and all which I get very inspired from it. So Quentin Tarantino, I love his work, I watch his work, but never try to do anything like that because it's very, it's only possible for him. And as you said about Maniratnam sir, you said like he made only one Telugu film.
Right.
But for Telugu audience, Maniratnam is a South Indian director.
Right.
Tamil people will be very proud for, because he's from
Tamil. No, it's not proud or whatever, but yeah, but in terms of watching the movies.
See, because of Ram Gopal Varma, I'm very proud because he's from,
right.
We have that thing at the end. But every film of his will release in Telugu. He has this very good market in Telugu, and most of the films are like Telugu films only.
Right.
Even if you see the Dalapati in Telugu, right. It's like a Telugu film only because Rajinikanth is a universal star and all, and like we love his work. Even Roja. Roja was like biggest hit at that time. Even Bombay ran very good. All his films, most of his films.
Right.
Which the films which didn't work in Tamil didn't work in Telugu, okay. That's it. But there is no film which worked in Tamil and didn't work in Telugu kind of thing. So like he's not a director who made only one film in Telugu. He made like all his films are Telugu films also.
Yeah, yeah. So one thing about what you just said, you mentioned that two things actually. One is you said that you were inspired by this film, right? Pulp Fiction. And how do you define plagiarism and inspiration? Because from what you said, it's clearly inspiration, but how does one, like supposing you take the feel of somebody and put it in your film.
I think there is a quote in Fight Club.
Right.
Everything is a copy of a copy of a copy of a copy. I follow that.
Okay.
I think that's true.
Okay.
Most of the stories have a source.
Okay.
I mean, it's my perspective.
Right,
okay.
Right, right.
I'm not telling you what I'm saying is true or not. See, most of the films when I go to a theater, I know like, oh, this scene from, okay, this scene. I follow like that. But when I make a film, I give credit to the people whom I get inspired from. If you see my first film, the first thing which appears on the screen is special thanks to ViewTorrent, IMDb, Google, all these illegal sites, because from which I downloaded a lot of movies, watched them and all.
Right.
And then another quote is like, I copy from whichever film I like.
Right.
That quote is, Quentin Tarantino said that. Like. So I get that quote with Sudheer Varma, Ram Gopal Varma and Quentin Tarantino.
Right.
So when a person sees that quote and starts watching the film, he doesn't go into that, oh, he copied from this thing or he got inspired from this thing. He's just following the film because I openly admitted it that that's what I
did. So that's why you prefer telling it before.
Yeah. After, see, when you, if I don't tell that, you might have asked like, did you get inspired for that scene from Swami Rara from Pulp Fiction?
Yeah, yeah.
Other than giving that explanation like, oh, it's there.
Right.
Many people try to hide it. But I just tell openly like this is what and I can't tell the names, but in this industry we know like some film comes, I was writing this screenplay and I called my writers and I gave one DVD to them.
Okay.
This is the film which I got inspired from and this is the plot. But if I don't tell you the DVD, you will never know that that's the inspiration from that. So I gave them the DVD and after they saw the DVD, they said like, sir, we met so and so X person. He said similar things from this film. So I called him. He's a very good friend of mine. What are the scenes which you got inspired from that film? So that like initial stages only, we can avoid this thing. So he said like only these parts Anna. Ah, okay. That's not which I'm using. So that's how I am. Like, I think both are same. As long as you know what you are doing.
Right.
You can tell whatever loo to cover up and all. But if you see something, if you get inspired, you are copying it from that.
I love the quote that Jean-Luc Godard said. He said, it's not important where you take it from. Mm. What's important is where you take it to.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a great quote because it's, he says, I don't care if you're taking it from somewhere. I'm just interested in knowing what you
how
do with it.
Well, you present it and how well it merges with the film which you're telling.
Right.
You see a great scene and though it doesn't require you in your film, you want to put it out, it doesn't look good.
Yeah.
You have to get inspired exactly in the story. It has to come and fit in.
Right.
That at that point of time, it's no wrong. I mean, nothing wrong in getting inspired.
I think you kind of answered this question. I wanted to ask you how, when you, what is the challenge of watching a lot of foreign films like you, but writing for an Indian audience? But you kind of answered that, right? It's like a,
see, I start a story with an idea. I might have got it.
Like Rana Rangam, right? Your new film. What is the core idea? I mean, how did it start?
The core idea is from Godfather.
Right.
It's a gangster film, but none of the scenes are related to Godfather. But the idea from Godfather 2.
Where father and son.
Father and son, you're showing both, like how Vito Corleone came to here, how can Michael Corleone is becoming huge.
So two parallel stories.
Two parallel stories. That's the idea I got inspired from. Then I got here, I mean, I started writing it and I want to tell it in, for the Telugu audience.
Right.
So anything I have to start in present time. Then I want to go to the past and see an incident which triggers the hero to become a gangster.
Right.
So I searched for that thing. So in 95, N.T. Rama Rao became chief minister for the second time.
Right.
94 end. As he becomes the chief minister, his promise in the elections was, I will ban liquor.
Okay.
So the prohibition will be there. So as he became the chief minister, first signature was like to end liquor in Andhra Pradesh.
Prohibition, yeah.
Prohibition was there. So I took that part. So the prohibition is there. Hero is in his early 20s. Now he is in Vizag.
Right.
How he starts smuggling this from Orissa is very near to Vizag. How he starts smuggling, and there are always the political people who are involved in that.
Right.
And the clash between them, like how he becomes a gangster, is a story in that part.
Of the father.
Of the, I mean, not the father and the son. Here I am showing Sharwanand at 25 and 45.
Okay, okay, the same, okay, right.
The
right.
same guy at that part yeah, time yeah, and
okay,
this time.
Right, okay.
Like that. So that's the screenplay. It's not. The story has nothing to do with Godfather.
Right.
But the basic idea is from that.
So when you say you're inspired by a lot of foreign films, what you're basically saying is that you take things that might help you push the story along.
No, I write the story.
Right.
Then if there is a similarity between this scene and from the scene which I watched in a film, I try to get that essence in this scene. Not that I see the scene, I like the scene and want to push it in that film.
Right.
Not like that.
Like you just said about the opening scene of...
So, it should fit in my story. I have a very big book where I write each and every idea or a scene or a dialogue which I like from a movie which I watch.
Okay.
Or from a web series or anything. I write in that book. After I write a story, then I go through this book, whichever is...
Right.
Related to this. Then I watch those movies again.
Right.
See, if my scene is better than that movie, I keep my scene.
Yeah.
Or if I think that that scene which I saw in that film is more effective than what I have on my paper, then I try to club these two and make a new scene.
Like a new scene. But you're always aware that the sensibility should be like local.
That's the main important thing. You never... miss the sensibility. If you miss the sensibility, you're gone.
Right. But tell me, when you just mentioned that you were in a theater and they screened Reservoir Dogs and people yelled at them and said, stop this movie.
Mm.
And they preferred this other film, Road Trip. Mm. That's the sensibility, right?
Yeah.
But you're the guy who watches Tarantino and all that. So how can you say your sensibility is...
can never get Tarantino into Telugu.
Right.
Reservoir Dogs is from... totally for my kind of people.
Right, but if you are, if what I'm asking is, if you are the Reservoir Dogs kind of guy and you're making movies for the Road Trip kind of audience, isn't there a clash there?
So, I'm not making totally for the road trip kind of guys. I'm merging somewhere in between. Okay. That's the reason I'm not a big director. Okay. So, I go in my path. I have my thing and most of the actors are like, they love to work with me. That's my thing. And I'm very happy with what I'm.
So, you're open to the fact that tomorrow a big star may come and say, okay, let's push you towards road trip. That's an okay thing for you?
There are few people who ask me to do a commercial film and I can't write a commercial film. So, what I told them is like, sir, if you have a
script
or some writer tells you a script and if you feel like Sudhi can do a good job with this, I will definitely work with you, sir. But me writing, I can't go into that
zone.
I won't have that thought of writing for that big star and all. Because when you are writing for a star, everything counts. Because what I feel is, for an audience to come to a theater, first is the star.
Right.
Or it's Rajamouli and Trivikram. That's the only thing which is very true.
Yeah.
Other than the star, no one else can pull a guy to a theater. So, normally without having anything, he doesn't become a star. So, once he becomes a star, you have to follow him. Because he has his ideas and he knows his audience, his fans and everything. So, that's the reason if they have a story, that's very easy for me to like get into the story and direct it.
And they didn't have a story?
Might happen in future.
Okay.
I mean, this happened recently.
Okay. What is this fascination with this crime world? Ranarangam is again set in that gangster world, crime world. You have this crime comedy kind of things, crime caper kind of thing. Why is that one world so fascinating to you? Is that a like secret kind? I'm really a good guy in life, but in my fantasies, I want to explore the crime world.
I'm definitely a good guy, but I feel like somehow whatever I write, it goes to crime.
Is that right?
I won't get any other idea to get out from there. This producer, Vamshi, who's producing this film, first he said like, you write a love story. Vamshi, we'll do a film. You get me a love story, I'll direct it. If you ask me to write a love story, see, for me, when I'm writing a screenplay or a story, I can't write scenes, hero-heroine meet, again, next cut to the same people at their houses and cut to the same people meeting again and all. I can't write that. I need to have something going on related to crime or anything.
Okay.
So
it's just a personal interest.
Personal interest and like and that also I can't experiment on what I am not very comfortable in with a producer's money and a hero's career thing. If I'm very comfortable and confident, I'll do.
Right.
Or else like just to come out of this crime thing, I can't, since a producer is ready to put a money and hero is ready to do, I can't experiment on that.
Right.
That's what I feel. If I write a story without crime and all, I'll easily direct it. But right now, whatever I start, something
keeps drawing you to that world.
Yeah.
How did you learn how to write a screenplay? Because that's one thing people keep talking about is that
whatever I learned to become a director are from the films I saw.
So you just broke them down and said,
yeah,
this first scene, second scene, third scene, this is what happens. Yeah. So is it an instinct kind of thing?
I write the scenes like, for example.
Now talk about your first film, right?
Becoming an AD was the toughest thing in my life.
Right.
I easily became a director.
Yeah.
Because I was working for a film called Veedu Theda as a chief AD and the producers were friends of mine.
Right.
And they saw my work in that film and all and they said like, Sudhir, we'll do a film after this. And Nikhil is a very close friend of mine. So he's ready to do my first film.
Right.
So that's when they gave me an office and then they told me to write a story.
Right.
So none of the ADs get that chance. So I started writing a story. Have you seen this film called Pusher? It's on drugs, French film.
No.
There is an idea from that film which I started writing on it. This hero is a drug peddler. So he takes drugs from antagonist. Like if he takes 10 grams, he makes it, mixes something else, makes it 13 grams and 3 grams is his profit.
Right.
So he sells it. That's when some other guy calls him and tells like, I want like huge amount of cocaine. There is a big party happening and all. So he goes, convinces the antagonist and like, give me one day time. Morning I'll take the drugs, sell it, get the money and evening I'll pay you.
Right.
he wants him very much, and that's happening. When these drugs, this thing is exchange is happening, the police will come. As the police come, he runs with the drugs, get into the water and put the, he dissolves all the drugs in there. Now he is debited to antagonist. That's when I am very hooked to that point where he gets something, misses it, now he has to pay, how he pays. So I started writing on that, and all my friends told why to go on drugs. Telugu, in Hyderabad, there is not much of a drug culture at that time So I left that. Then I started, I started this story, and then I was very fascinated with this Anant Padmanabha Swami, that treasure and all So I started developing what some idol gets, stolen from there.
Right.
No one knows its value. And then I started writing, so I want a villain to get involved in that. Hero, heroine, just start their love story, and at one point of time, that thing should get connected to these people.
Right.
And the second half should be the drive between all of them.
Right.
That's what I had in mind. And then I started developing the story. I wrote the story of how these people involved. And then I wrote the villain thing separately, other villain thing separately, and the climax separately. Then I started joining them. So in the flowchart, I have all the hero scenes.
Wow. Your engineering really helped you.
Yeah. And then I have the villain scenes. At what point of time I can cut this hero thing and go to that. So that the people will be engaged with the love story and as well as what's happening to the idol and all.
Right.
So that's how I wrote my screenplay. Then I added the characters wherever. And in Swami Rara, there is not even a one character who is not involved in the story.
Right.
Not even a one character. So Dasara Narayan Rao Garu, he praised me a lot. I never knew that much I made in that film. While making, I never thought of that.
Right.
He had that idea this is what happened.
So that's how you kind of, it was almost an instinctive thing.
Yeah, instinctive thing. The only thing which I keep in mind while writing the screenplay is none of the points should be left for a long time.
Right.
If there is a villain scene, it should be engaging, coming at the right point of time so that the audience feels this is also happening.
Yeah, so you don't lose any track for a long time.
No.
Okay. So that's your golden rule. So your golden rule is don't lose any character or any situation for a long time.
Long time.
Okay.
Or if you leave that thing also, the time it comes back should be a shock.
Okay, right.
Just like that Pulp Fiction scene.
Right.
No one will expect till when the climax comes, everyone will be forgetting about the first scene. Suddenly, those two people get up from the background.
Right.
Same in Swami Rara, this idol thing, I said we shouldn't lose the track of the idol, it should be coming in.
Right.
But the first scene where the Jogi brothers kills, I left it there till around 1 hour, 15 minutes or something, then it comes. So that will be a shock. People will forget about what happened there. And now this will be a shock.
Right. So in terms of screenplay, what are the recent Telugu films that have really impressed you?
I loved Jersey.
Right.
That's a brilliant, brilliantly made film. Care of Kancharapalam.
Right.
And then Arjun Reddy.
Okay.
Care of Kancharapalam, I was watching it, Rana called me for a preview. I was watching it. And one of my friend Chendu, who directed Kartikeya and Premam in Telugu, we were both sitting and watching. And I was telling him, somewhere in pre-climax or something, what the last thing is there, you saw the film, no?
I saw the film, yeah.
The four characters is of the same person. Yeah. I was telling him, we should write a story where four ages that, I didn't
realize that
it's going in ages.
Right.
I was getting that idea, and then I thought that I was shocked to see that. That was a brilliantly made film. And then Arjun Reddy, I loved how we opened, how we got back, and again, it was very young. See, Arjun Reddy, it was around 3 hours, and I saw next day was the release, and the previews were there previous day. Families came, old people also came, and the movie started at 11 o'clock in the night, and by the time it got over, it was around 2:30 or something. And people were still sitting till the rolling titles were done. I was shocked. I mean, like 3 hours film, and still the people are like that much engaged in that.
Right.
That and Kshanam.
Right.
That was a brilliant screenplay thing.
So, would you say that right now, Telugu? I mean, I've asked a lot of people this. I've asked like big directors, this, small directors, this, medium directors. I've asked heroes this.
Mm.
Would you say that this Telugu film, you know, these small films that keep coming, like Kerav Kanjirapalam, you know, right from Pellichuplu before that, all these little films, they make a lot of noise. Then you get one maybe three, four months later, and then again, maybe you get two or three a year.
Mm.
Is this a movement, or is it a, like, just these odd little films that are coming up every now and then? Has the basic Telugu audience changed, or is it just like a few people in the cities watching these films?
No, see, what I think is, like, any film you make, you should know, like, who are your audience are.
Right.
That's where the budget comes into the place. Swamirara, I made it on 1.7 crore. I know that only A centers are my audience. So, I don't have a huge star to pull the crowd on.
Right.
So, I know first day will be very minimal collections, and then if people tell that the movie is good, then people will start coming.
Right.
So, that's my idea, and like that's how I put it. You can't make Care of Kancherpalam with a 20 crore or something.
Right.
So, whatever film you make, if you make in that budget and for that audience, you will never fail.
Right.
So, these small films, recently, agents Rai Srinivas Athreya, Brochevar Avaru, and they came in like 1 or 2 weeks span, every film ran very successfully.
Okay.
The success is like, see, a big film which collects around 30 crore gross on the first day, this film will collect only like below one crore. Still, that budget should work because that's the budget you put into that film. So, whatever you're trying, if you work on that budget, you can make films. But what you said is like Telugu audience, if you make a decent film, good film, definitely they will watch it.
But are you talking about the all Telugu audience or only in the city's Telugu audience?
Wherever, whomever your target are.
Right.
See, if I'm making a mass film, the BC centers will be my target.
Right.
Because in the villages, those people might like it. The basic example and the best thing is, if it is a mass film, it runs very successfully here, but it won't collect much in overseas.
Okay.
For example, Bunny's film Sarai Nodu. It's a huge blockbuster here, but it didn't collect that much in overseas.
Right.
See, a film like Pellichuplu,
right,
it's like top 4th or 5th in this thing, but it won't collect much in BC centers.
Right.
You can't make a film on thinking that I want to impress each and every Telugu audience.
Right. You have to be very clear about it.
Very clear thing.
Okay. So, who are you targeting with the Ranarangam,
I'm targeting like ABC centers.
Wow.
Because it has that in that film.
Okay.
My previous films were none of them. My films, I targeted everyone. My previous film, Keshava, it made profit before the release.
Right.
I mean, like, not the theoretical thing. Only with the non-theoretical rights, I got the money which we put in the budget of that film. So, theoretical rights was just our profit. So, that was my aim. I know, like, BC centers won't come to this film. Only A centers, this thing. That was my target. And I made that film in that budget.
Right.
For this budget, I targeted everyone.
Okay.
Though it's crime, and it has a love story, it has a family thing, but it's targeted to everyone.
So when you target a film to everyone, does that mean that you can't be as edgy as you want to be?
Yeah, definitely.
So what is compromise? So does the, you have to have more songs, you have to have more action sequence?
Not like that. While writing a story only, it's not like compromising, like, no, I have to put a fight here and all.
Right.
Whatever the fight is there in that situation, you make it commercial.
As opposed to? Like what?
For the audience.
Okay. Okay.
See, if my friend is kidnapped, I can design a fight like I take a gun, shoot three people and get him back.
Right.
Or I can go barehanded, fight with 5-6 people.
Right.
Fighting with 5-6 people is commercial.
Okay.
This is edgy.
Edgy, okay.
So, at the end of the day, hero is going and he's getting his friend back.
Right.
That's the same in both cases. So, to make it more to the audience and all, I design a fight there.
But then in theory, every story that you write can be made commercial, right?
Definitely, it can be made commercial. But you have to have a star or producer to put the budget in.
Okay. So, it's just more expensive.
Yeah. It's like 2 hours work for him to go and shoot three people and get.
Right.
3 days work for him to go and fight.
Yeah. So, it's also
you have to put a budget
for that.
Budget and all.
Okay. All the best for Rana Rangan. Thank you so much for coming here.
And it was a pleasure and always wanted to do an interview with you.
Thanks so much. Yeah, thanks. All the best.
Thanks. Hi, I'm Sudheer Varma. If you like this interview, subscribe to Film Companion South.